Since Thomas Aquinas College, New England, opened over a year ago, some major renovations have taken place inside their new chapel. The Northfield School enlisted the help of some local craftsmen to complete the work needed to convert it into a Catholic house of worship. Steve Kiltonic visited the campus to find out what was involved in the chapel transformation.
When Thomas Aquinas College, New England, was looking for a contractor for some much-needed work on its 111-year-old Our Mother of Perpetual Help chapel, they didn't have to look very far. Larry Rue, a parishioner of Our Lady of Częstochowa in nearby Turner's Falls, had the skills to build the chapel's brand-new confessionals and altar railings. A residential housing designer by trade, Rue worked on a number of woodworking projects for the parish, including the construction of church altar rails, reliquarium, and a choir loft. He also designed and constructed the Polish Martyr Chapel for Father Dimas Scola in the parish's cemetery back in 2012.
It's a nice change to get away from the computer and get behind the equipment and doing woodworking, especially if you can be. I love the Gothic architecture and the Gothic woodworking, so this church was ideal.
Prior to opening in 2019, Aquinas College made some major changes to the former Sage Chapel, built for the Northfield Seminary for Young Ladies, to convert it into a Catholic house of worship. Before their convocation, other interior renovations were done, including the construction of a new floor plan, a central aisle, altar, and tabernacle. Assisting him on the project was George Creston, a 2003 alumnus of the college. Harrison Architects from Washington, D.C. designed the entire chapel project.
They gave us elevations of the confessionals, what they wanted, and they gave us a set of plans from a previous set of confessionals they built in Alabama to use as a prototype. They wanted to match the interior of the church, so you can see the paneling on the walls matching the paneling on the confessionals, and the stain and all that's going to match, and the door styles, so all of matched the existing architecture in the church.
The project was completed before the doors opened for TAC's second academic year last fall. Planning and actual work on the confessionals started in the winter of 2019 and continued into 2020 before the pandemic slowed the process. Rue said it took several weeks to convert the initial design into shop drawings so the various components could be prefabricated.
So the confessionals are all constructed out of red oak, which is what's inside the church right now. So you have to locate all those pieces, bring them in, then prefabricate them, cut all the pieces. Then we actually prefabricated the entire confessional in my shop and then tore it down, brought it here, and we're reassembling it.
Creston worked on most of the confessional pieces in the campus woodworking shop.
Working this as a team, I'm kind of like doing the stuff in the shop, and George's kind of like doing all the field work to assemble it and finish it up and trim it.
All of the components had to be rough cut, trimmed, and custom made by hand to fit in the chapel. Rue built the heavy confessional doors at his own shop, then brought them to the college for Creston to complete the detailed finish work.
These are the doors for the confessionals. Solid red oak, 2 1/4 inches thick. They were really heavy. George is in the process of making all the jams and the casings, which is even more work because you got to do all these jigs to laminate, make these arches.
Father Greg Markey, the college chaplain, served on the chapel renovation committee.
We wanted confessionals there where the students would have easy access in and out and be able to use them in a way that would facilitate their relationship with Christ. So we took certain designs and carvings that are present, for example, in the windows themselves, and we incorporated them into the design of the confessional, and so that there would be one continual theme throughout the entire chapel.
Inside, the confessional had crucifixes and a traditional screen between priest and penitent. Low-voltage lights indicated when the confessional is occupied.
And then when they leave, the lights go back off, or the outside light turns green from red, so to speak. So on the priest, inside the priest's side of the confessional, he has switches that can run the interior lights. He can dim them, you know, set the whatever kind of mood he wants for the confession.
The confessionals are also soundproof to make them more safe and secure.
There's more light bells and whistles, so to speak, and it's just to make it easy and functional and beautiful. An important part of the sacraments is beauty. The church is historically a patron of the arts, and we do things beautifully, and we should make the confessionals beautiful. So you'll see finely carved woodwork designs and carvings throughout the entire confessional.
The confessionals took about 4 months to finish, not including the time to get the drawings together. The end product is something that looks like it always has been part of the chapel. The altar railings were created after the confessionals and were also hand-carved to match the church interior. This is what the altar looked like before, with only one existing altar rail in the upper-level sanctuary. This section was eventually retrofitted and redesigned, but an entire new section was also created. Again, Harrison Architects designed the plans.
They shipped us schematics of what the school wanted for altar rails, and so we're taking measurements off these plans and prefabricating each of the separate pieces.
Rue cut all of the altar segments in his own woodworking shop, then preassembled them in his garage. They were reassembled at the school by Creston.
The whole front of the altar rail is about 43, 44 feet long, and then it has two sections of 10-foot sections on each side. So it's close to 60 feet worth of altar rail to build at the lower altar rail. The center portions are the two gates. There's two gates, which you can see, which is what we have in the background there. It's all done out of red oak, and it's going to be all stained and varnished when it's completed.
The railings included 30 panels, each of which took at least a day to carve.
We do the extraordinary form of the Roman Rite here, and so receiving Holy Communion at the altar rail is part of the Roman Rite in the extraordinary form. So this was an important part of the construction, and it gives the sense of delineation that this is the sanctuary, this is the Holy of Holies, this is where God's sanctuary is, the tabernacle.
The college is very pleased with Rue and Creston's handiwork.
These are tremendous craftsmen who live locally. We were very fortunate to find them. They're both men of deep faith. Larry and George have been a tremendous team, in both good to work with, professional, and we love the final product.
And the students, faculty, and alumni of Thomas Aquinas College, New England, will forever be grateful for their craftsmanship on display in Our Lady of Perpetual Help Chapel. For Real to Real, I'm Steve Kiltonic.
Some beautiful craftsmanship.